Hello students, welcome to Biology Reward. Today we are revising the chapter Heredity and Evolution. So evolution topic is deleted for this session. So we are discussing regarding the heredity. Students, it is the revision part. So we are revising the topic which are in our NCERT book. First, heredity, variation, monohybrid cross, dihybrid cross, and sex determination in human. So let's come to the heredity and evolution chapter. As a heredity and evolution, first we should remember what is heredity. Students, I told you, we look similar to our parents, or some of the our characteristics are similar to our father and mother both, because they transfer from father and mother to us. So the characters are traits which transfer from the parent to the babies, parent to the progeny, parent to offspring, parent to children, and it is called the heredity. So heredity is the branch of science which deal the study of transmission of character, transfer of characters or trait from parent to their progeny. When we look to the similarity, but we are not exact the carbon copy of our father and mother. No doubt we have some similarities with our parent, but we are not exact carbon copy of our parent. The reason is that the differentiate between the characters or trait among the individual of the same species are called the variation, because the gene of father and gene of mother, they come together with us, and by mixing and recombination of the genes, then we have the some different character as our parent, as compared to our parent. So it is variation. Variation, it means difference in the progeny as compared to their parent. So heredity and variation, these are the two important parts of our genetics branch. Here in the picture you can see the birds are also having the difference in variation. Insects are also having the difference in the size and color also. The grapes are also having the differences in the color. So all these shows the variations. So heredity is the transfer of character from parent to babies or offspring, and variation is the difference in the new progeny as compared to their parent. Second important part is the when variation come, what are the main reason for the variation. So when we are discussing variation, so variation due to the variation in germ cell, or variations change in the somatic cell, and this type of change in somatic cell is means body cells come as well as germinal cell come. So this is called the variation, and the variation is come due to the mutation. Different type of mutation we will study in the higher classes. So variations come due to the mutation. Here you understand whatever change come in the progeny, so this changes of one progeny will go to the next generation. So one organism reproduce, the offspring which is having the some little bit variation. When one organism reproduce, the offspring is having the some variation as compared to parent, because their inaccuracy in the DNA copying. DNA copying is done, DNA replication is done, and improper DNA replication or inaccurate DNA copy, some variation come in the progeny. So when organism reproduce, offspring show the minor variation, and this is due to inaccuracy of the DNA copy. Now these variation are very less in the asexual reproduction, but more in the sexual reproduction, because in asexual reproduction only one single organism is involved, but in sexual reproduction the two organism of opposite sexes are involved. So the chances of variation in a reproductive sexually reproductions are very high. Some variation now are useful. Some variation are useful, and they help the organism to adjust to the change in the. So according to the environmental changes, organism itself get adjusted, and this adjustment is done due to the some variation. So some variations are very useful because the organism adjusts on cell according to environment. But some variation do not help the organism to adjust to the changes. So this, in such cases, the variations are harmful for the organism, and even the organism can die or they can be extinct. So variation is accumulated generation to generation. This is the storage of the variation in generation to generation. That variation is useful or it is harmful, that is the different thing. But the variations, those are useful, that variation play the important role in the evolution process. In the process of evolution, so variation is very important or vital phenomenon for the process of evolution. After this variation and inheritance, so we are discussing about the inheritance means the character which are passes from the one generation to other generation, and it is called the inheritance. So rule of inheritance of traits or character. As a cell is having the nucleus, inside the nucleus there is a chromosome. In the chromosome there is the DNA molecule, and in this DNA molecule there are the genes which are determining the characters. So characters are transferred through the genes present in the DNA molecule in the chromosome in present in the nucleus of the cell. So you can see that nucleus is present in the cell. So cell is having nucleus. In nucleus there is a chromosome. Inside the chromosome there is a DNA, and that DNA segment is called the gene. So this gene is responsible for the determination of the traits or character. The inheritance of character is due to fact that both the father and mother character are contribute equal amount of genetic material to the child. For such traits are two factor, one from father and one from mother. Students, when father genes and mother genes, the equal contribution of genes of both paternal genes and maternal genes, it means a gene of father and gene of mother, and due to this one gene the characters come in the progeny. So each trait, there are two factor, one is from the father and other is from the mother. So about this inheritance, the idea is given by the Gregor John Mendel. Before that nobody was knowing about the inheritance. So Gregor John Mendel conducted the experiment with the garden pea. Garden pea, it's known as Picum sativum. So Gregor John Mendel conducted the experiment in the Picum sativum in the garden pea, and he gave the some theories, some principle that determine the rules for the inheritance of tail. So that is called the Mendel's is called the father of genetics, because the Mendel has given the some rules for the inheritance by conducting the experiment on garden pea. Garden pea is Picum sativum. So for this contribution he is referred as a father of genetics. Second important part in this one, you can see in the diagram. So the cell, inside cell there is a nucleus. Nucleus, inside the nucleus is chromosome. In chromosome there is a spiral like structure, it is DNA, and this DNA coil structure, a segment of DNA is called the gene. So this gene help for the determination of the characters or trait. Mendel selected pea plant for his experiment. Why is Mendel selected pea plant for the experiment? Because the pea plant was easily available. It has the very short lifespan. There were many contrasting characteristics. Okay, for this purpose, the Mendel selected the pea plant. Pea plant is also bisexual. Okay, and self pollination and cross pollination can be achieved, and that's why Mendel selected pea plant for his experiment. So when Mendel selected the pea plant, he studied 7 pairs of sample differences trait. He studied the 7 pairs of characteristic, and these 7 pair of characteristic one by one we are coming. First characteristic is flower color. He selected some flowers are purple color and some flower white color. So one pair of contrasting character, flower color, it's purple color, or we are saying violet color and white color. Second character was seed color. Some were the yellow seed and some green seed. So yellow seed and green seed. Third character, shape of the seed, and that is smooth shaped as well as wrinkle shaped. Okay, smooth shaped or wrinkle shaped or round and wrinkle. Third characteristic was the seed shape. Then fourth is pod color. Pea pod was green color or somewhere yellow color. Fifth character is pod shape. It is implanted or it is the wrinkle shaped. Okay, so flattened and pinched. And next character, six, was the height of the plant. Some plant were the tall and some plants are short. And for flower position, 7 pair of character, axial condition and as well as terminal position. So flower position, axials are terminal. So these are the 7 pair of characteristics studied by the Mendel in May plant. In class 10th, we have to at least remember violet flower or purple flower and white flower, round seed and wrinkle seed, yellow seed and green seed, tall plant and short plant. Okay, so one characteristic is the dominant character and other characteristic is the recessive. Suppose purple flower is dominant character over the white flower, yellow seed is the dominant color over the green color, round seed is the dominant character over the wrinkle seed. Okay, so tall plant is a dominant character over the short plant. So these are some dominant traits and recessive traits. So here we should understand the 7 pair of contrasting characters studied by the Mendel. Second important part is, when plants having one pair of character, tall or short plant, was crossed, so it is called monohybrid cross. So what is monohybrid cross? A cross between one pair of character. So when one pair of character are crossed, this cross is called the monohybrid cross. So Mendel selected pea plant having one pair of character, tall pea plant and short pea plant. So tall pea plant and short pea plant are crossed. He selected pure tall is a phenotype character, and for the genotype of pure tall is capital T. Genotype is a genetic constitution, genetic makeup of his anatomy, and this is represented by the alphabets. English alphabets are used. If character is dominant, then it is expressed as the capital letter, and if character is recessive, it expressed as a small letter. So pure tall is a phenotype character, and what is the genotype for pure tall? Capital T. Okay, so the genes occur in pairs, so and that's why alleles also occur in pair. So alleles we are writing together. So for pure tall, what is genotype? Capital T. Whereas is pure short plant, it is the phenotype character, pure short, and genotype for the character is small t. So he selected pure tall plant, capital T, and pure short plant, small t, and it get pollinated. So after the pollination, in F1 progeny, first filial generation, he got the tall plant, and this tall plant capital T and small t was the genotype. So capital T and small t when cross and F1 generation, capital T, small t come. So phenotype is tall plant, but what is genotype or the F1 progeny? It is capital T and small t. Then when he cross the F1 progeny, self-pollination is done. So there self-pollination in F2 generation, 4 progeny are obtained. This is pure tall TT1, hybrid tall capital T small t 2, and pure tall small t 1. So ratio came 1:2:1. It was the genotype ratio in F2 progeny. But the phenotype ratio, 3 are tall and 1 is a short. 3:1. So by monohybrid cross, the Mendel's explained that when tall plant, pure tall plant and pure short plants are crossed, in F1 generation, tall plants appear. So tall plant is a dominant character. And short plant was hidden in F1 generation and it expressed in the F2 generation. So the character which do not appear in F1 generation and express in the next generation is called the recessive trait. So here tallness is a dominant character and shortness is a recessive trait. So in this also we have the ratio. That ratio we are getting in the F2 generation, phenotype ratio is 3:1. Students, you can see the monohybrid are in 3 crosses are given. One short plant and tall plant when we are cross, Mendel cross, then F1 generation 100% plants appear tall plant. When short plants and tall plants are crossed, then F1 generation 100% plants appear as a tall, and tall is because tall is a dominant trait. But this plant is self-pollinated. In such cases, F2 generation ratio is obtained. It was 3 tall and 1 short. It is 3:1. It is the one monohybrid cross. Second monohybrid cross is when the violet flower and white flower, they cross. So F1 progeny, all the violet flower, 100% flowers appear violet. But this F1 progeny is self-pollinated. So F2 generation, what happened? 3:1. 3 are violet flower and 1 is a white flower. So it is also monohybrid cross. Third one, as round seed is crossed with the wrinkle seed. For round seed, genotype is what? Capital R. And wrinkle seed, small r. So F1 progeny is having round seed. But what is the genotype of F1 progeny? It's a capital R and small r. So when F1 progeny is crossed now, self-pollinated, so F2 generation, what happened? 3 round seeds and 1, it's a wrinkle seed. It means 75%, 3:1 ratio come on, 75% it's a round seed and 25% a wrinkle seed. So all the 3 cross, so the monohybrid cross. So by monohybrid cross, the Mendel explained that the phenotype ratio is 3:1 and 1 character is dominant character which appears in the F1 progeny. And other character is recessive character which do not appear in F1 progeny, but it express in the other generation. Now after the monohybrid cross, when plant having 2 pair of characters were cross, then it is called dihybrid cross. So what is dihybrid cross? The cross between 2 pairs of contrasting character is called the dihybrid cross. So Mendel selected 2 contrasting pair. Number 1, round seed and yellow seed plant. For round seed genotype, round seed is capital R, and yellow seed genotype is capital Y. And it is crossed with the wrinkled green. Yellow wrinkle is a genotype small r, and green is the genotype, it is of small y, small y. So when capital R, capital R, capital Y is crossed with the small r and small y, so F1 progeny, all plants appear, it's a round yellow. And genotype was capital R, small r, capital Y and small y. So in F1 generation, 100% plants appear, these were round and yellow. So round and yellow, these are the dominant traits over the wrinkle, over the wrinkle and green. So F1 progeny, what is the genotype? Capital R, small r, capital Y and small y. Now this F1 progeny, then these were self-pollinated. So when F1 progeny gets self-pollination, so four gametes will be formed, and these gametes are capital R, small capital R, small capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, then small r, capital Y and small r, small y. So four gametes are formed. So these gametes, when self-pollinated, one father and mother, so in F2 generation, he got the 16th progeny. And this 16th progeny, out of the 16th progeny, 9 had round and yellow, 9 round and yellow, 3 had round and green, 3 had wrinkle and yellow, and 1 had wrinkle green seed. So ratio in F2 generation come 9:3:1. So it is the about dihybrid cross. Then after the dihybrid cross, this also flow charts Punnett square, it is called, and it also shows that the ratio in dihybrid cross is 9:3:1. And last topic now, it is the determination of sex in human being. Students, human being, we have 46 chromosome in each cell. It means 23 pair of chromosome. So in nucleus of the cell, each cell is having the 46 chromosome, it means 23 pairs of chromosome. In these two type of chromosome, one autosome, these are the 44, it means 22 pair, and sex chromosome, it is the one pair, it means in male it is XY and it is female, it is the XX. So out of two chromosome, sex chromosome X and Y, the male has two XX chromosome, female has two XX chromosome and male has one X and one Y chromosome. So you remember, sex chromosome in female XX, and sex chromosome in the male, it is one X and one Y. The sperm and egg have one set of sex chromosome, it means they are haploid. Some sperm have X chromosomes and some sperms have the Y chromosome. So the two type of sperms are there. So male is heterogametic because it produces two type of sperm. Some sperm have the X chromosome and some sperms are having the Y chromosome. So male is heterogametic. Whereas female produces same type of egg, the egg is having only X chromosome. So all eggs have X chromosome. So female is homogametic. Now what happened? If the sperm having X chromosome is fused with the egg, understand? If the sperm having X chromosome fused with the egg, then child will be girl. Because sperm having X chromosome fused with the egg, the child will be girl, because chromosomes, sex chromosome will be XX, so that is female. If sperm having Y chromosome fertilized with the egg, egg is having X chromosome, the child will be boy. So here it is chromosome which decide and determine that the sex of the child. If the sperm having X chromosome fertilized with the egg, child will be female or girl. And if sperm having Y chromosome fused with the egg, the child will be, newborn child will be male or boy. So it is all about revision part of our chapter, heredity and evolution. Evolution part is already deleted, so we have to read only heredity. And heredity, what is heredity, what is variation, monohybrid cross, their ratio, dihybrid cross and ratio, determination of sex in the human being. These are the very important topic for the chapter. Thank you.